I lay yesterday's debacle wholly and solely at your door.
You know why she ran away?
She ran to hide her head in shame because her husband's sister is a putana.
I know what I'm doing. I was Queen Bee around here for years, and I'll be Queen Bee again. I have no intention of giving up that title to a gutless contender like Claire Agar.
Aha, we haven't retired.
Well, retired be damned.
When he heard what happened, he broke off the engagement. I'm afraid she no longer has a fiancé.
Oh, poor girl.
Also, she came here to get married. And if she doesn't get married, she'll be deported.
What do you think you're doing?
But Mrs. Davidson, it's buy-up day.
Put all that stuff away. There will be no privileges for prisoners until further notice.
Right. Everything ready for the buy-up?
Mrs. Jackson, you are aware that I have cancelled all privileges. That includes the buy-up.
Yes, but they're so used to it.
When I say all privileges, I mean all privileges. Well, what are you waiting for? Mrs. Jackson, I'd like a word with you. I understand Mr. Wilson was in this morning.
Yes.
You knew why he was here?
Yes, I did.
And you admitted him?
That's right.
Knowing he has already had one visit with Travers this week.
Look, he's here trying to help Irene Zervos. And Karen's the only one in the prison with even a smattering of Greek.
Nevertheless, you have contravened the rule of allowing one visitor per prisoner per week.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson, but he was really seeing Irene Zervos, not Karen. And I do believe Irene needs the help.
Your function is to assist me in the administration of this prison, and that means sticking by the rules I make. Do you understand me?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Getting so touchy lately, isn't she?
I suggest we put all this stuff away.
That's lovely, Angie.
Got your bluff, hasn't she? Got everybody thinking she's Tin Pin.
Oh, let her. Let the brainless tarts follow her.
They'll see it my way when I'm ready. I wouldn't hang by me thumbs, love. Oh, hello. Anybody here smell olive oil? Oh, nothing personal, love. I just must be feeling a bit off. Must be coming down with a wall.
If you weren't so contemptible, you'd be totally pathetic. How would you like it if you were faced with the possibility of being deported?
Ah, good riddance.
You don't understand. Irene came out here to get married. Now it looks as if she's going to be sent back.
Serve her right. If she's stupid enough to go on the game and get caught, she's got to take what's coming to her. Why'd the stupid cow do it anyway?
I don't know. I haven't been able to get through to her well enough to find out.
If ever you do, just tell her to keep out of my way. I've had enough of her kind outside.
Clara, you're supposed to have some control.
I hope so.
Well, then get Monica off Irene's back, will you?
That's a good idea, Tinkerbell. Why don't you sort money out? Show her who's boss around here.
Have you done your timesheets?
Yes, did them this morning.
Well, well, efficiency seems to be contagious, doesn't it?
Sorry?
Well, even our worthy governor seems to be getting her act together.
I think she's overdoing it, overreacting.
Oh, I don't care what she's reacting to. It's about time this place was run as a prison and not a holiday camp.
So out of character for her, though.
What, doing a job properly, you mean?
Reception. Yes, Mrs. Davidson. Excuse me, Miss Bennett. The governor would like to see you and the duty staff in her office straight away, please.
Well, here we go. More of the get tough policy.
Thank you for coming so promptly. I have some news for you which may slightly disrupt the running of the prison for the next few days.
Why? What's wrong, Mrs. Davidson?
Well, I don't know that anything is wrong, really. In a way, I suppose it was to be expected. I have been notified that the department is appointing a visiting justice to investigate the running of the prison.
Because of the barbecue?
The letter merely refers to various incidents.
After all, the list's as long as your arm.
I'm sure some of you know Mr. Goodwin, the stipendiary magistrate. He has been appointed the visiting justice.
Oh, he seems a fairly reasonable sort of a chap.
Yes. Of course, he will want to question all the officers. I hope we are all agreed in our attitudes when the time comes to speak to Mr. Goodwin. I wouldn't want to confuse any of the issues he may have under investigation. We will also have to advise the prisoners that the visiting justice is coming and tell them of their rights.
They don't deserve any.
Whether you like it or not, Miss Bennet, they have rights. And I suggest we tell the prisoners they can appeal to the justice about any part of prison procedure and about any disciplinary action which they consider excessive. That is all, ladies. Thank you.
I suppose this may mean a few changes, Mrs. Davidson.
Poor Erica. Having this investigation right on top of that barbecue mess.
Couldn't be better timed, in my opinion.
Oh, come on, Vera. You can see what a position it puts her in.
What about yourself?
Me?
There are certain advantages in being deputy governor, you know.
What are you talking about?
Well, if I were to be governor, you'd be the most logical choice to be deputy governor.
I don't want promotion if it means having to sacrifice Erica.
Don't worry, Meg. You won't have to do a thing. And let me tell you, once I'm governor of this prison, things are going to be run very, very differently.
Oh, boy, can you smell that?
I certainly can.
It's cabbage. I love boiled cabbage.
I think it's revolting.
Yeah. Maybe I just got used to it. Or maybe I got a tapeworm. Yeah, that could be it. I could have a tapeworm.
Oh, I don't think so, love. Tapeworms are choosy.
Oh, Bea, don't be disgusting.
Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Goddard. I forgot we don't talk about tapeworms here in track, do we? Oh, here comes a little grease spot again. Listen, there's none of you minced-up goats in vine leaves here, up. None of that dago crap today.
Leave her alone.
You keep out of this. Maybe you'd be more at home in a fish and chip shop. Here, or maybe the Olympia Cafe. That's it, Olympia. You know that word, eh? Olympia, Olympia. Olympia. I don't give me any of that dago crap.
That's quite enough. Come on, everybody. Inside. Come on, move along. Not you, Ferguson. I want a word with you.
What do you want?
I suppose you think you're very smart.
Look, if I was that smart, I wouldn't be.
Play your cards right and you could get out earlier than you expected.
Why?
You've still got 1 month of your sentence to serve. But the parole board meets next week and there's a good chance you'll get a 3 weeks remission.
What's the catch?
Just start treating that Greek girl like a human being and not like an animal.
Oh, look, she doesn't understand a word I'm saying anyway.
All right, if you think it's worth 3 weeks of your time in here to insult her, just keep it up. As I said, the parole board meets next week.
You're not such a bad screw after all.
I'm just suggesting you make it easier on yourself.
Yeah. Well, look, I'm sorry you got hurt the other day. It was an accident.
I'm all right. But you're apologizing to the wrong person.
Hey, I thought you were going to stick up for Irene.
Yeah, it's not fair the way Monty's been treating her.
Yeah, why don't you do something about it, Clara?
Oh, wake up to yourselves. Tinkerbell's gutless, aren't you, love?
Just wasn't the right time.
Yeah, never will be.
What about right now?
Oh, I don't think lunchtime's the appropriate time.
Watch her footwork. Watch her footwork.
You're not frightened of me, are you, Clara?
Oh, of course not. It's just as I said, it's a matter of timing. Very well, then.
Very well what?
I will talk to her.
Oh, this I've got to see.
Go on, Clara.
Monica, I have something to say to you.
Yeah?
It's about the way you treat Irene.
Yeah?
I think you're being most unfair to her. She's a stranger in our midst, and she doesn't speak the language. And I think you're being too hard on her.
Oh, you do, do you?
Yes, I do.
Well, maybe you're right. Sorry about that, kid. Abby Jay can't be all that bad.
You were terrific, just terrific.
It's nothing. It's just a matter of being reasonable, that's all.
Geez, I would never have been that game.
Είναι αδερφή σου. Πρέπει να την βοηθήσω με.
Δεν μπορούμε να κάνουμε τίποτα χωρίς να παραδοθούμε στο immigration.
It's completely against regulations for you to be in on this visit.
The governor authorized it.
Yes, well, that's something I'll be taking up with her and with the VJ.
Look, σε το θέλω, ήρθα τε.
Stop that at once.
Θα σε βοηθήσω με, αδερφή μου.
Speak in English.
For God's sake, Vera, she only understands about a dozen words of English.
I don't care. It's regulations. Either you speak in English or this visit ends before it begins.
What?